Alrighty, guys, let's go ahead and get started. Welcome to our weekly outlook. Today is the weekly outlook for the week of November 4th. If you are on my part of the world, I'm in Thailand right now. It's actually the week of November 5th. Because for us on this side of the world, the markets are open Monday through Saturday instead of Sunday through Friday. But welcome, guys. I hope you guys are all, you guys had a very nice and relaxing weekend. I hope you guys are ready to jump into the markets this week, and we're just going to jump straight into things. But I do want to introduce myself. For those of you guys that are new here, my name is David Schinkel. I am the CEO and founder of Positive Traders. I've been running Positive Traders for a little bit over for 2 years now, and I've been doing these weekly outlooks for free just about every single Sunday. I maybe miss 1 or 2 weeks out of the year, but other than that, we are on here every single Sunday grinding out a bunch of free value for you guys and giving you guys as much value as possible. If you're watching the replay, go ahead and if you're watching this replay on YouTube, go ahead and make sure you subscribe so that way you don't miss any future weekly outlooks, and click that like button and leave a comment if you get a lot of value out of this. But before we jump into things, guys, I do just want to give you my disclaimer that this is just my opinion, guys. I am one human in the markets that is, you know, has an opinion on it. So this is my opinion, and it should just be looked at as that. This should not be constituted as financial advice or investment advice. Please use what you guys hear as educational and informational purposes only, and maybe just kind of help you along with seeing the markets on a bigger picture. And to segue into everything, I also just want to mention that I am a higher time frame trader generally, right? The principles and the practices that I use in the market and my strategies can be applied to lower time frames. However, on these weekly outlooks, I am not working with lower time frames. Only on my daily webinars for my students, Monday through Thursday, do I talk about, you know, maybe lower time frame setups, but right now, this is going to be my bias for the overall week. So, you know, I can have a bias on something and it can completely go against my bias for, you know, the first 2 days that the markets are open. And then at the end of the week, go with what I was looking for. Or maybe it happens early on in the week and then we see that move completed early on in the week. So keep that in mind, guys, that every chart that you guys see me put up, like right now that you guys see on the screen, is a weekly chart of the dollar index. So we're mostly going to be looking at the weekly and daily. Some charts we might, I might drop it down to the 4 hour, but please keep that in mind. But all seven of these, by the end of this weekly outlook, guys, you should all have a very clear understanding of at least these seven pairs that you see to the right here that are flagged, of what I'm expecting, where I'm expecting price to go. Maybe some of them, even some entries, that type of thing. But first and foremost, I want to look at the economic calendar. Keep in mind, guys, I am not in the western part of the world right now. I am out here in Thailand, the beautiful city of Chiang Mai. I really encourage all of you guys to get out here if you ever get a chance. It is awesome. The energy and vibrations and just everything out here is great. Lots of entrepreneurs and other people in the same mindset. It's actually really crazy how awesome it is out here. But with that being said, this time is Thailand or Chiang Mai time. So, you know, if you're on the western part of the world, like I'm sure a lot of you guys are, keep in mind that your time zone is going to be completely different. So if you're using the economic calendar, make sure that in the top right where you see my cursor over here, it's set to the same time where you are. So it's actually 8:09 in the morning where I am right now. But just to touch base on a couple of the key risk events for this week. So early this week, we have the RBA, Reserve Bank of Australia, releasing a rate statement and a cash rate at the same time. Looks like they're going to be keeping interest rates the same, but that could cause some volatility with the Australian dollar. A lot of other high impact or red folders I'm not going to get into. Right now, I'm just going to talk about the key risk events in middle of this week, middle towards the end of this week. We have the RBNZ, so Reserve Bank of New Zealand. Same thing as the Reserve Bank of Australia earlier this week or early on this week. We are having an interest rate decision, a rate statement, and monetary policy statement all released at the same time, and they are supposed to keep interest rate decisions the same. And then towards the end of this week, we have the notorious federal funds rate, FOMC statement. So if you guys have been following the Federal Reserve this year, which I highly recommend, guys, you put some emphasis on fundamentals, right? The markets are not just about trend lines and support and resistance. It's very important that if you want to take trading seriously and if you want to build an income off of trading and maybe even transition to becoming a full-time trader down the road, that you really put emphasis on understanding the big things like interest rate decisions, GDP, CPI, PPI, understand how money is moved between banks, between central banks, and the fundamentals that actually is the true driving factor of the charts. So we do see that the federal funds rate, they actually are looking at keeping interest rates the same. And if you guys have been following the Fed this year, they talked about earlier this year, or even last year, planning on raising interest rates this year 4 times. And if you guys look at the history this year, we've seen them raise interest rates 3 times so far, okay? Meaning that if they don't raise in there is 8 of these per year, okay? So there's 8 of these meetings per year. You can actually see right here, frequency scheduled 8 times per year. This is the 7th one on Friday, okay? So on November 9th, or where I am, November 9th, it's going to be the 7th one. So there's one more in December. So just use common sense, guys. Federal Reserve said they're going to raise interest rates 4 times. They've only raised them 3 times, and they're not raising it on this one. And this is the 7th one. So when is the last interest rate hike going to happen, right? Raising interest rates, most likely coming in December, unless they change their mind and they decide 3 is enough this year, then we aren't going to see anything in December, but there's a very high probability, very high likelihood. As of right now, the way it looks on the books, obviously there's going to be an FOMC statement. So I'm going to be reading through this statement. If you guys, want to learn more about this, like you just come on here and you guys see right here, this little hyperlink that says latest release, you can click on latest release and you can go in and you can actually see the meeting calendar. And then it's going to have a link to actually look at the meeting minutes. So you can actually see right here, look at this. This is all this year. All right. And don't ignore this, guys. Like don't just be rolling your eyes right now and saying, I don't need this. I can just, use my strategy on the charts. There's going to become a time and a place when your strategy that you're using in the markets right now and in your technical analysis doesn't work. All right. You're going to have to be adaptive. You have to understand that the market is like a human body. It's always changing. So you need to have as much information and always be learning and just know as much as you can. So that way you're prepared when the markets are evolving and changing. Okay. So on here, you can see all of the statements and then you can see the meeting minutes. So we're going to see an FOMC statement. So right here, let me get my marker out for you guys right here on at the end of this week, when the statement happens, you're going to see the same thing like right here. You're going to see a PDF and an HTML link, okay? And then you can just click the little PDF link like we can just show for September, and it's going to pull up this whole thing, right? And if you guys are not committed to your success, if you guys can't spend, spend a little bit of your time instead of scrolling through Instagram and Twitter and Facebook and watching random YouTube videos that are probably doing no good for your well-being or for your financial future, make that decision, guys. I mean, it's up to you. I can only lead you guys to water, right? You can lead a horse to water. You can't make them drink it. So it's up to you guys. This is awesome, by the way. We almost have 50 live people in here. This is great. I see a lot of comments in the chat, guys. I will get to that. Actually, I'll just take a peek right now. Positive traders have crypto involvement. Jake, yes, we do have crypto involvement when it happens. Actually, guys, keep your trades or keep your questions. I'm not going to get all to them now because there's a ton of them in there already. I don't want to take away from what we're doing right now. So keep that in mind. And then also at the end of this week, we have right after the federal funds rate, we also have a monetary policy statement being released for the Australian dollar. And then we have GDP for the pound. Okay. This is going to be pretty big. We have preliminary GDP as well as month over month GDP. And then the preliminary GDP is quarter over quarter. Okay. So lots of high impact news. Okay. And if a lot of this is going over your guys' head, that's totally fine. You guys know that one of the reasons I'm in Thailand right now is I am building a course. It's 73 lessons. It's going to be hosted on a Teachable website and you're going to have full access to going through every single thing that I have. And it's no fluff. And, in regards to that, a lot of people want to call people out for selling courses. They say people make money off of courses. Guys, I've been running Positive Traders for over 2.5 years and I have not had an official course, right? So it's just time to release something so everybody can be on the same level that I'm at. So keep that in mind before you guys call people out for selling courses, right? I didn't come right off the bat 2.5 years ago just selling a course right away, right? I've been giving out signals and profitable signals and a profitable trade copier. And, I've proved my proved my my skills over the past couple of years, but a lot of people want to know how I do it now. So that is coming out on December 1st. There's more details all over social media, but first thing I want to look at before we jump into these seven setups is the dollar index and just kind of explain to you guys what's going on with the dollar, how I feel about the dollar, and what's happening. First and foremost, write completely blank chart, just looking at what the markets are doing. I hope most of you guys can see this. We have an inverted head and shoulders on the dollar index, right? We have this very strong inverted head and shoulders. And I've been telling you guys for the longest time that I am bullish on the dollar. Like, not even just weeks, guys, months and months and months, if you guys have been following me. Ever since really the beginning of this year, or not the beginning of this year, but middle of this year in May, right here when we broke this downtrend, that's when we really started to pick up our buying bias on the dollar index. Okay, so let me drop this down onto the daily, or actually first let me throw this on the weekly and let me show you my markups. I also see, so just so you, I don't know if you guys can see that, so the neckline of this, I'm gonna actually lay that right there. Okay, so we have the low back in April of, that's 2016, so going back pretty far. And then we have marking off the current neckline right now. Okay, so when this zone gets, oops, when this level right here gets broken, okay, if and when we break this, we're going all the way up to at least back top of this range, 100.50. And if you guys have been following me for months or years now, you guys will know we've talked about the 100.50 and the 93.2 level being a very significant range on the dollar index, okay? So that is that. Let's just drop it down onto a lower time frame and let me just kind of give you my thoughts. Oh, also very quickly, we can see on the weekly time frame right here that we're finding some very, very strong resistance. Okay, so this is my long-term outlook on the dollar. I'm expecting long-term bullish movements on the dollar. Now, over the next couple weeks, don't get this twisted, guys. Okay, so that's my long-term outlook, but we need to break that neckline first. Okay, this neckline is probably not going to be broken easily, especially with the price action that we've seen over the past week. We see a very, very strong doji, or you know, that's kind of a cross between a doji, which is a neutral candle, and an exhaustion candle at the top of price, forming a little bit of a double top, which we'll look at on the daily in just a moment. But my bias for this week is I am still bullish on the dollar. However, I think we could see some downside on the dollar index. And I think especially with Euro USD, we're going to see upside maybe over the next 1, 2, or 3 weeks. We'll see this downside on the dollar. Okay. So just because you guys hear me talking about that higher time frame on the weekly in the inverted head and shoulders and overall price action is long-term bullish, right? We've been bullish for a majority later half of this year. We can still see price drop again before moving up higher, okay? And that's what I think is very possible to see happen. So if we look at the daily, you know, just to kind of recap from last week, we saw a very, very, very strong rejection off of these highs. This is a form of manipulation. This is something that I talked about on the daily webinars with my students, is a lot of times people will mark off the original high, right? This is the yearly high for the US dollar. Let me just double check. I believe that's the yearly high. Yeah. 2018 high. Yeah. That's a 2018 high that we had previously had right here. Pretty much 96, 98 that you can see. And last week, for the first time this entire year, we saw the highs broken, okay? And what a lot of people do is they have FOMO. They chase this trade, right? They see, as a retail trader, they say, okay, this high was broken. You know, we closed pretty bullish. We've been in a nice rally, and the high was broken. So pretty much people's analysis is just because the high was broken, they buy. Not only that, but a lot of traders will have buy stops. They'll have pending orders above the highs where, okay, they assume that if the highs get broken, it's automatically just going to continue going higher. So, and that's not always the case, right? That's not always the case. And we're seeing that happen right here. We're seeing where manipulation comes into play in the market makers. They push price just above the highs. So that way it tricks everybody. Everybody has FOMO because nobody bought down here. Not a lot of people bought down here because they don't know how to read the charts, so they aren't confident in themselves. So they wait until it's too late. They wait, okay, I should get in. Okay, I should really get in at this high. And then they buy right at the high, which maybe some of you guys are in that same boat. Maybe some of you guys bought the dollar, which would be selling Euro USD last week. And now, you know, you're in a bad situation, which you have to just be careful about that. But we see sellers run price down, strong bearish engulfing candles. So there is definitely a strong level of resistance in this zone. And I think that's what's going to create a bit of selling pressure this week. Not just that, but I think the market makers really need to take out a lot of the buyers that have been buying and expecting long-term buys in this area. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see the dollar index really fall this week and really move lower, which is going to push gold up, which is going to push Euro USD up, which is what I'm biased towards. So let's get into the setups, guys. Let's go over what I'm expecting. First things first, gold. I'm expecting gold to rise. 1265 is my level. I'm not going to get super into every single pair this week, guys. I don't want to be super repetitive for those of you guys that are doing your due diligence and being on all of these weekly outlooks, because I've discussed why I'm expecting gold to go to 1265 multiple times. It's the underside of a trend line that we've had since 2016. It's also the 50% retracement level of our previous swing high to swing low. So if we retrace all the way back up to the 50%, that would be a pretty confluent level with the underside of this trend line. And then not just that, but we've been bullish, right, for a little bit now. But we have been kind of consolidative. So a couple months we were consolidating around these lows. Finally, a couple weeks ago, middle of October, we broke this range. We've been really consolidating ever since. We saw some really nice manipulation. I mean, not nice, but what I mean is textbook, right? Just classic manipulation at the end of the end of the week before last, where we saw the highs right here broken, where a lot of people FOMO and they buy at these highs. And then we saw price go all the way down. And I will take credit for this, 100% credit. If you guys were on last week's webinar, I specifically drew on gold this exact move to the downside. I said price was going to drop most likely past, oh, that's actually cool. That's a line. We can do all sorts of stuff with this. Okay. I said that we are going to drop past the support level, which we did, and we are probably going to drop past this level as well. And that was to stop out everybody that bought all the way in this area, okay? And this is enough to blow people's accounts if you don't have a stop loss, because gold is very volatile, okay? And now we're seeing the true move, right? We're seeing a big push up. We saw a big push up at the end of last week, and then a nice little bull flag happening. So my bias is to the upside. I believe we're going up this week on gold. Remember, guys, this is just my opinion. Do not just go and place a buy on gold because I said it's going to go up this week, okay? There's a very good chance that we could see manipulation happen, and just like we always see manipulation, because you don't think, guys, if we can see this bull flag on the 4-hour, okay, use some logic, okay? All of the market makers, everybody, the banks, everybody that actually controls the banks can see this as well. Not only that, but they can see everybody's orders, guys. Okay. I don't know if maybe you guys don't understand, but that market makers or liquidity providers, that's another word for, those are all just words for banks. Okay. And at the end of the day, your broker, whoever you use as a broker, sends your order off to a liquidity provider, an LP. Okay. And that is a bank. The bank fills your position. It's not the broker. The broker is a middleman, okay? I've kind of said this before, but it's like being in a restaurant, right? And you're the customer, your broker is the waiter or waitress, and the chef that actually completes and makes the meal for you is the liquidity provider, okay? So the waiter is just a middleman. Your broker is just a middleman that gets your order to the liquidity provider, you know, and make sure, you know, well, they take their cut with the spread, right? Or if you have a commission on your trade, it depends on what type of account you have set up, but you get what I'm saying. The liquidity provider can see all of this. So at the end of the day, they can see where every single person's buy is at. They can see how many people are selling, how many people are buying, where everybody's buy stops are at, where everybody's sell stops are at. Okay. So, you know, it's, you guys have to understand that manipulation and banks is what moves the market. It's not because you see a pattern that pattern is going to get completed. Like, just because we see a bull flag doesn't mean that price is going to continue going up. It depends on where banks need price to go. And that's why risk management is so important, because you can never be 100% on a single setup. Okay. So that's why I always use low risk, no matter what, no matter how good the trade looks. Okay. So again, very good chance, market makers and banks see that everybody sees this bull flag. They know that. They know a lot of people are buying in this area, and they're probably going to push price down one more time before moving price higher. And that's going to hit the stop loss, right? That would be 1233 to, let's say, like 1223, right? That's 100 pips on gold. 100 pips on gold is a very big move, right? You can lose a lot of money, or you can make a lot of money. So, and with that too, don't take a sell just because I said it could go down before going higher, guys. Wait for confirmation, okay? And I teach that confirmation on my webinars and my course that I'm releasing. So it's not something that I have all the time in the world to go over today, right? I mean, if you guys pay attention to my weekly outlooks and you guys are on my webinars, you should understand by now. So EURUSD, how do I feel about EURUSD? Well, again, the opposite of the dollar index, right? From a weekly perspective, right? We have a very large head and shoulders being formed on AUDUSD. Okay, big head and shoulders. But if you guys are familiar and you understand how to trade a head and shoulders, a lot of people want to like sell at the top of of the right shoulder. And that's not the way, that is not the way at all to trade a head and shoulders. The proper way and the correct way to trade a head and shoulders is you wait for the neckline to break, and then generally either some form of consolidation or a retest, however that structure plays out, but you always wait for the neckline to break. And in our case, the neckline is not broken. But what I believe is I know, again, going back to manipulation and market makers, they see that everybody sees this, right? They see that everybody sees this head and shoulders, and they know that everybody wants to sell in this area. So everybody's putting on fat shorts on EURUSD right now, when the reality is we're actually seeing a pretty strong double bottom in this area. Now, I need more confirmation, okay? One bullish engulfing candle. This bullish engulfing candle from Thursday is not enough convincing to me that this is a reversal, okay? Especially because there's an exhaustion candle right here on Friday. We could see this downtrend just resume and us just continue to go lower and that head and shoulders work out. And if that happens and we see that neckline break, then of course we're going to switch our bias and we're going to be to the downside on EURUSD. And we would look for a big move to the downside, right? We would fib this move out. And we probably look to, I bet right around there is like the 61.8% retracement level. I'm actually curious to see if that, what level that is. Let's see. So if we draw this to right here, okay, well, I was way off on that. 61.8% retracement level would be the next target. And then we'd go lower towards a full retracement. Okay. But we're talking about here and now. Okay. We're talking about what's going on right now. And you can see actually on the weekly, very the same exact thing as the dollar index, the opposite. Instead of it being at the top of the market, it's at the bottom market. And we're seeing a little bit of a bottom form. We saw a doji form last week, which is a neutral candle. So really my confirmation is going to come throughout this week. If this week on EURUSD, we see a strong bullish engulfing candle, like a strong blue candle form, and the week close off like that, then I am going to be very, very biased that price is going to make a retracement, and price is going to make a retracement probably all the way back up to 119 or higher. And then, I mean, because that's just so much confluence, right? That would show strong buying pressure. That would confirm that, because this week is still possible. We could still see a drop from EURUSD in this long-term downtrend that we've been in since the middle of this year, or early beginning of this year, resume, right? But I don't know if it's going to happen like that. I'm more biased towards a bottom forming in this area and some sort of pullback, right? But if we get this formation at the lows, then that's going to be a nice morning star if you guys are familiar with chart patterns, and we should see price go up higher. Two most notable setups also is AUDUSD and NZDUSD. So this is a pair. If you guys are in the signals group, you know that this is a trade that we took last week. Very, very nice trade. Very small stop loss. Very big take profit. We were originally risking 50 pips to make 348 pips. Now this trade is closed, so I'm actually going to go ahead and delete this, but just wanted to show some of you guys that are maybe hopping on for your first time what to expect if you are a part of our signals group. It's always trades like that. It's not always as big, but I always look to make minimum double what I'm risking. Okay. So worst case scenario on a trade like that, where we were risking 50 pips, I would have looked minimum to make 100 pips. But in this case, I see opportunity for more upside. And that was came in the form of 350 pips. Okay. Now, if you guys look at my trend line, don't look at this descending trend line and let it be, you know, the be all trend line. Okay. Because technically we are still making a series of lower highs, right? If you just see all these lower highs and lower lows, right? And that's what creates a downtrend. That's how we know we're in a downtrend. Although we broke this trend line, right? This high right here, this lower high, still needs to be broken for this to be considered a reversal. Okay, for this to be officially considered a reversal. I picked a bottom. I saw the Wyckoff method. If you guys are familiar with the Wyckoff method, we saw a nice accumulation down here. Then we saw the spring, which was inducing and getting the liquidity that the market makers needed for a buy. And then we see price push up. Okay, so it is very possible that what we saw with this push is just another lower high, right? Because if you just look at it logically, right, there's our previous lower high. This could be a next lower high and we could continue going down lower, right? I'm going to become a little bit more aggressive. And when I mean aggressive, I'm not talking about using more risk. I'm just talking about putting more emphasis on finding a setup on this pair if this lower high is broken, right? If we see this lower high broken, then we have officially, from a textbook standpoint, made a reversal, and we would, you know, be looking for a series of new higher lows and higher highs to be created with this pair. Okay. So just kind of keep that in mind, guys. You know, don't let my trend line, or if you have the same trend line on your chart, don't let that be like the be all trend line. Okay. Because we are still in a downtrend on this pair, but you know, we saw the Wyckoff method. We saw the accumulation. We see the Australian dollar extremely oversold right now. So there are, and we actually also see the 50 EMA. You guys see that 50 EMA all the way down there? 50 EMA was penetrated and broke through at the end of last week. So there is definitely conviction to the upside, but in my opinion, we need more conviction in the form of this lower high being broken. NZD, USD, same exact thing, guys. Although we do have good price action and a lot of conviction to the upside, we had that nice little double bottom, and then we had the price drop, where this is what we can call a liquidity grab. That's where the market makers push price lower to trick everybody that it's going to be, you know, a long-term sell and it's going to keep dropping. So everybody sells at these lows right here, and that provides the liquidity that the market makers and banks, whatever. I just say market makers need to push price higher. And that's exactly what we saw happen. And if you have been following along with my weekly webinars, I challenge you guys, if you guys are brand new here, go and watch, spend 20 minutes of your life and go and watch last week's weekly outlook. And you'll literally see before any of these moves happened last week, I called this. I said all of this, guys. I called all of this. I said upside on AUDUSD. I said upside on NZDUSD. There's no denying that, because the proof is in the pudding, right? Documentation beats conversation at the end of the day. And it's all documented right there on my YouTube channel for you guys to go and watch and audit my, you know, my doing. Okay. So again, with NZDUSD, we have been making a series of lower highs and lower lows, right? We're obviously in a downtrend. I'm sure many of you guys can see that. So if we look at where our previous lower high was, this is why I have a lot of I believe that there's a lot of conviction also on AUDUSD moving higher, because on this pair, on New Zealand dollar, US dollar, on the Kiwi, we actually have broken the previous lower high, because what I just circled, that is the previous lower high, and we have broken that. So now we are making a higher high, right? This is our original high, or our lower high, and now this is a higher high because it's higher than this high, right? And then we have our low right here, and we have a higher low. So the next logical thing would be maybe to make, like, do something like this, make a higher low, and then boom, make a higher high. And if we see this happen, then that's going to be a lot of conviction for AUDUSD also moving up. Because if you don't know, these two pairs, not only do they look very similar, right? You switch between the two charts, they look very similar. But if you guys have never looked at a map before, New Zealand is right off of the coast of Australia, right? And there's nothing else around New Zealand. Like, all there is ocean to the right of New Zealand, right? All the way until you get to the other side of the world, which would be whatever's on the other side of the, I would have to look at a globe, but just being honest with you guys, AUD USD, Australia is to the left, and they have their economies are very similar. They rely on each other for trade and trade balance and imports and exports, everything. So even their exchange rates are very, very, very similar, right? Only a couple cents off from each one, okay? Let's look at NZDJPY, okay? NZDJPY, I'm actually going to remove that right there and just show you guys some raw price action, okay? I've actually been watching this pair for a while, okay? So if you guys have been following me on the weekly outlook, this is something I posted. This is for free on my trading view. It got a lot of views. And this is all the way back to July. Now, granted, this trade idea we got stopped out on. However, the overall idea, right? I said imminent downside starting up here. We saw that downside and we saw this very complex formation form. We see a very complex, I call it like a quadruple bottom. It was a triple bottom at first. And then now we have a quad bottom. Very, very, very strong buy zone right here, right? Very strong demand level for NZDJPY. And I believe that if we break through the current resistance, which we're going to definitely have to break through, right? We're probably going to do something like this first and then make a move to the upside. If we break through this resistance, we're going to keep going up higher, okay? And we're going to go probably back up to this trend line. That would be a pretty nice target to look at. I think also if we throw in a fib level, not a lot of confluence with, oh, actually a little bit of confluence with the fibs, right? We have the 50% retracement level right there. So we'll see what happens, but I believe that there is upside to be seen on this pair. Let's go ahead and look at Euro AUD. So if you guys are again in the signals channel, you'll know that this was a trade that this trade just, I couldn't ask for a better trade, right? These are the trades that I really like. This is a trade called early last week. This was our original target, right? That was our take profit, our area, which was 65 pips for 156 pips. So already that was a good risk to reward ratio, but we just saw it just absolutely melt last week, right? And so I will now delete this since you guys have seen that. And where are we at now? I believe we're going to see more downside. I'm actually going to keep these trend lines on here. I'm going to actually extend. No, you know what? I'm going to remove both these trend lines, or I'll keep. Sorry, I keep just being indecisive. I'm going to remove those trend lines just so you guys can see a clean chart. So we do have a level of support right now on Euro AUD in the form of a trend line. I think we could find a little bit of a bounce in this area, but overall, if we look at the weekly, we have a strong, strong resistance level at these highs, right? This has been proven to be a couple structures that bounce off one, two, three, and four. So this is a strong area of weekly resistance. And I believe, especially if we see these previous higher lows or even this higher low right here broken, if we can just get price a little bit lower, do something like that, massive, massive downside on this pair. Not only that, but think about what pair this is, guys. Euro versus the Australian dollar. And what did we just talk about with the Australian dollar being extremely oversold and expecting maybe a lot of upside coming up on the Australian dollar? Well, that would be the catalyst, most likely the catalyst for this pair to continue moving lower, okay? So not only that, but if we look at this on the daily, right, from a daily perspective, right, this original range that we were in, we broke last week. Right? So there's a lot of conviction to the downside, but there's also some short-term conviction to the upside, right? We have a trend line. We know how well price likes to bounce off of trend lines, but I would not buy this. I would not be looking for the buy. I do think price has a chance to move up. I would be looking for the true move lower. Okay. And then Euro GBP, I'll get into right now. Guys, this is your chance to write some questions. I think there's like eight comments or questions. I don't know if they're all questions or whatnot. I haven't even looked, but I'll get to them in just a moment. If you have any questions, write them in the chat room. I'm not going over any other pairs that are not listed here, guys. So please don't ask me to go over a pair that I haven't talked about. These are just the pairs that I like. And I don't think it's fair if I just give you some cheap, short, really quick analysis, right? I really like to take my time on things. And these are just what I like right now. So, but if you have any general questions about Forex or anything that I've shown you here or what I do, throw them in the chat room and I'll answer them. But Euro GBP, okay? So I have a couple markups on here. If we just look at a blank chart and you just mark off the major, major, major weekly support that we're sitting on right now, and then obviously this would be our next support level. This has been created a pretty complex structure, right? But we have a lot of resistance in this area, right? That's kind of our liquidity zone. And what I'm looking at, I'm most focused on is obviously current price, right? Where the support of this major, major, major weekly support is at, okay? And I believe it's as simple as this, guys. As long as this support is broken, that we are gonna see continued downside to this next support level, okay? This next support level down here. And what's really cool is if you fib out this move, there's a lot of confluence. This is why I like the charts, guys. And this is why, you know, the technicals can add so much confluence, but you still have to understand fundamentals at the end of the day. But right now we're just talking about technicals. Look at this, the 38.2% retracement level. Look at this line. Just perfect, perfect confluence with this previous support area over here, okay? So this is definitely like pretty much 8.84 on the dot is, I mean, you can see right here, it's 0.83978, right? So if we round it just up 3 pips or not even 3 pips, it's 0.84. Nice even whole number. And look at where price is at, guys. That's 350 pips from current price. This is a very nice clean move to the downside, okay? But I'm telling you that if we break through this, and I'm not saying just if we break it, guys, okay? Because we could see manipulation happen and a break and then price come back into this range. I'm talking about conviction behind that break, okay? More like a weekly close, okay? If we see a weekly candle close below this area, maybe this week, then we'll look for maybe a retest to make sure that this isn't a fake out. Look for the structure, see how complex the structure wants to become, maybe a bear flag. Who knows? We're gonna have to evaluate price action if and when that time comes, but most probable scenario would be price moving down to the 0.84 area. And again, that's a three from current price, that's 363 pips. And I'm not saying to sell now and catch all 363 pips. Obviously you wouldn't catch that whole move because you got to wait for the conviction and then, or I'm sorry, the break and the confirmation. And then you have to wait for as much evidence as you can that will add confluence that this pair is going to keep going lower. So, but you still could get probably anywhere between 250 and 300 pips to the downside on one trade, guys. And depending on how you set up your risk to reward ratio, you know, let's say you only have like a 50 pip stop loss or an 80 pip stop loss, something like that. You know, let's say a 50 pip stop loss to make 300 pips, that's a 1-to-6 risk to reward ratio. Meaning that if you risk 2% of your account, you can make 12%, guys, on one trade with very, very low risk, okay? And by now, you guys should all understand the power of compounding, right? I'm gonna show it very, very quickly, take 30 seconds and show this. Some of you guys may have not seen this before. This is the compounding calculator. If you take a $1,000 account, right, and this is why you should always use low risk. If you just take an $1,000 account and you just let it grow, just a nice, easy 5%, per month long term, even less than that, you can make a lot of money, and you just let that sit there for the next 10 years and do its thing. That's $348,000, guys. I don't know any other investment. I mean, maybe like high risk investments. We're talking about low risk. I don't know any other low risk investment that you can get that you can make $348,000 on $1,000 in 10 years, right? You can either let your money sit in your bank account and grow with $1,000 and let it gain 1% per year for the next 10 years and make, you know, $100 on this in the next 10 years, or you can leverage Forex, learn the principles, learn the way to compound, learn the way to use good money management, learn the way to set up your trades in the right way so you can achieve this 5% per month and make hundreds of thousands of dollars, six-figure wealth. So maybe you don't want to be a Forex trader, or maybe you don't want to do it full-time, right? But at least you see that Forex can be a vehicle that you can use to go and do whatever you want to do with your life. Maybe you have a passion for opening up your own business or doing something, right? You want to go do whatever you want to do. Forex is a great vehicle to get there. Just like investing in real estate is a great vehicle to build wealth. Just like investing in, you know, having the S&P 500, the Dow Jones, investing in crypto, you know, all sorts of ways to build your investment, okay? But let me get to the questions in here. So we have Bahamas. Oh, nice. You're here from the Bahamas. Jay Cashers asks, does positive traders have crypto involvement? Absolutely. Obviously this year, since pretty much the beginning of this year, since January, a little bit after January, the first week of January, crypto has been in a major downtrend. So I will tell you guys right now, you're hearing it from me first. If you have not heard it from me already, I believe in crypto, guys. I believe crypto will go up long term. But do I believe it's something that should be day traded? Absolutely not. It is absolutely way too volatile to be day trading, in my opinion. And, you know, I'm a very low risk kind of guy, right? I mean, if you're all into that hyped and, you know, sweaty trading and emotional trading, then whatever, you can do whatever you want. But it's, crypto is something that I don't think should be day traded at this point. It's something that, you know, accumulate coins and hold on to them and hold on to them long term, you know, get some of the good ones like Ethereum, Bitcoin, Ripple, whatever the top ones. You guys know I made the call on Tron at the beginning of this year for everybody that was in Positive Traders at the beginning of this year on December 27th or December 28th. I forget exactly which day I told everybody in my group that I put $6,000 into a coin called Tron when it was at 3 cents. It went up to 30 cents, made a ton of money off of Tron, and everybody in the group did too. And yeah, so we are involved in crypto, and we will be more involved, obviously, as the bullish market picks up. Colin said, can't see your screen just showing a logo. Oh, I hope that wasn't for everyone. Says works video. Okay, unpin video, working for you. Okay, cool. Video is good. Moyo says, what do you think about a buy on Euro USD since now the 50% retracement from the recent move up? Well, I think you understand where I stand now, Moyo. Valerie says, great content. We'll watch us recording. Thank you, Valerie. Marta says, I'm glad this is recorded so we can watch again as there's a lot of great info. Absolutely, Marta. Feel free to watch it as much as you want. They'll be uploaded to YouTube. And Evan says, the video is good. Awesome, guys. Well, that is my weekly outlook for the week, guys. You have a very clear understanding of all seven of these pairs that I'm interested in. If you guys are a student of mine or connected to the trade copier or you get signals from me, you know, I think Euro GBP is definitely something we're going to be looking at this week. AUD USD and NZD USD is definitely something we're looking at this week. But have some patience, guys. Have some patience. We made some nice money last week in the markets off of our signals and trades. And, you know, it's not about just being in the market all the time. It's about waiting for the right setups and waiting for confirmation. So you be able to control your emotions and be cool with everything. Okay. Last thing, I will just make an announcement. I want to plug myself in real quick. For those of you guys that do not know, my lifetime membership is ending, guys. So that is lifetime membership to everything. The signals, the webinars, my trade copier with 0% profit share. Pretty much every single thing that I do, not pretty much, every single thing that I do with Positive Traders, I offer a lifetime membership. And obviously, that's very undervalued because it is a lifetime membership for the next 5, 10, 15, however many years I'm running Positive Traders and trading for people and doing all this stuff that I do. You have lifetime membership, and it's something that I'm not going to be offering anymore because it's too cheap. So I'm accepting, I think there's two more spots left. I'm giving a special promotion on my lifetime membership. So if you are interested in that, shoot me a message. But other than that, guys, I hope you guys have a great week. Evan says, awesome content. Looking forward to the great things to come with David. Waiting and patience is key. Thank you very much. Joshua says, great content as always. I appreciate you, Josh. Thank you, guys. Have a great week. If you're a student, I'll see you guys tomorrow on the daily webinar. If you are not a student, I'll see you guys next week on the free weekly outlook. Stay safe trading. Keep those risks low, guys. And keep positive attitude and control your emotions. All right. Take care, guys.